The next most asked question about Oracle Enterprise Manager is, how can I log into Oracle EM using HR user? Or how can I grant access of my Oracle EM to one of my non-admin user? Manish, please tell me, how can I do that? Firstly, I don't know why you want to do that, but since you have asked, then here you go. What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Welcome to the third tutorial of Oracle Enterprise Manager series. In this video, I will show you the process of granting access of Oracle Enterprise Manager to any user of your database. And by any, I mean it could be a newly created admin user or a non-admin user like HR, SH, or whatever user you have created. But first, a quick disclaimer. Granting access of Oracle Enterprise Manager to users of your database could lead to catastrophic event. Don't ever do that unless it's absolutely necessary. Also, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and press the bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video. Now, let's get started. First, let's see what happens when we try to log into Oracle Enterprise Manager using a user which is not sys or system, like HR or any other user. Here, I am on Oracle EM. For the demonstration, I will be using the HR user. Thus, the username will be HR. In my case, the password is also HR. This could be different in your case. Next, in the container field, we have specified the name of the container of our HR user, which is ORCLPDB. I have done a video on how to unlock HR user in Oracle 19c. You can check that out. Link is in the description. Anyways, let's hit the login button and see what happens. Okay, so we got an error, invalid database credentials. There is always a reason behind every error. Here, that reason is the privileges. Yes, in Oracle database, every user needs to have certain privileges to log into the Oracle Enterprise Manager. Now you must be wondering, Manish, what are those privileges? In order to log into the Oracle Enterprise Manager, every non-administrative users need to have either EM_Express_Basic or EM_Express_All role. EM_Express_Basic role, as the name suggests, gives basic privileges to the user over Oracle EM. It enables the user to log into the Oracle EM. The user of this role gets read-only privileges of the Oracle Enterprise Manager. In simple words, you can log into the Oracle Enterprise Manager and see what is happening, and nothing more than that. Whereas the EM_Express_All role not only lets the user log into the Oracle Enterprise Manager, but also gives access to all the functionalities provided by EM Express. Thus, in order to log into the Oracle Enterprise Manager using any non-administrative user, you simply have to grant either of these roles. Let's grant EM_Express_Basic role to our HR user and see whether we will be able to log into the Oracle EM this time or not. First, let's log into the database using the sys user. Done. Next, switch the container. If you have watched my previous videos, then you must know that by default, Oracle Engine connects us to the database through the root container. If the user to which you are granting these privileges is placed inside the root container, then you are good to go. There is no need to switch anything. Skip this step. But if this is not the case, then you have to switch the container to the one which has your user. For example, we know that HR user is placed inside the pluggable container whose name is ORCLPDB. Thus, we will have to switch the container from the root to pluggable ORCLPDB. Done. Step 3. Open the database. In order to perform any further action, we need to make sure that the pluggable database to which we are connected right now is open for read-write operations.
Let's first check if the database is already open or mounted. As we can see here, currently ORCLPDB is not open, rather it's in mount state. Now we have to open it. Let's do that. Great, database is open now, which means we are all set to proceed. Step 4. Grant the EM_Express_Basic role. Granting a role is very easy. We simply have to execute a grant statement like this. On execution, this statement will grant the EM_Express_Basic role to the HR user. If you want to grant the EM_Express_Basic role to any other user, you simply have to change the name HR with whatever the name of your user is. Similarly, you can grant EM_Express_all role. Anyways, let's execute this statement. Done. That's all we have to do. I have done a tutorial on what are roles and how to create one. You can check that out. Link is again in the description. Now, let's try to log into the Oracle Enterprise Manager using the HR user once again and see if we can do that or not. Let's refresh the page. Done. Now let's enter all the credentials once again. Username HR. Password HR. This time we don't have container name field. Anyways, let's hit the login button. Seems like this time we have successfully logged into the EM using the non-administrative user HR.
So that's how we grant access of our Oracle Enterprise Manager to a non-admin user, and for that matter, any user of the database. Hope you enjoyed watching. If so, then please hit the thumbs up button and like it. Also, share this video with your friends on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.